فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. In the explanation of the kitab تعظيم العلم written by الشيخ صالح ابن عبد الله ابن حمد العصيمي, we are on the fifth chapter. The Musannif said, وفقه الله.
قال المصنف وفقه الله المقعد الخامس سلوك الجادة الموصلة إليه لكل مطلوب طريق يوصل إليه فما سلك جادة مطلوبه أوقفته عليه ومن عدل عنها لم يظفر بمطلوبه وإن للعلم طريقا من أخطأها ضل ولم ينل المقصود ربما أصاب فائدة قليلة مع تعب كثير.
The author رحمه الله in this chapter المقعد الخامس, he chapted it سلوك الجادة الموصلة إليه. سلوك means to tread. الجادة, it means وسط الطريق. The word جادة means the middle path. In the middle of the path, it's called جادة. الموصلة إليه, that will allow you to reach it. The reaching here is معنوي, it's not حسي. There's a path, sometimes can be a path which is an actual path that you know, that you can touch, that you can see. And sometimes the path is معنوي. Seeking knowledge is a path, but it's not a path that you can touch. Then the author goes on to say, لكل مطلوب طريق يوصل إليه. Every path, everything, لكل مطلوب, everything you're trying to attain, everything you are trying to receive and gain, it has طريق, a path يوصل إليه, that will allow you to reach it. When you come into this masjid, there was a path that will allow you to come to this place. The same is when it comes to attaining knowledge. There is a particular path for it. فَمَنْ سَلَكَ جَادَّةَ مَطْلُوبِهِ أَوْقَفَتْهُ عَلَيْهِ. And anyone who takes the path, the middle path, جَادَّةَ مَطْلُوبِهِ, he takes the middle path of the thing that he is trying to attain. أَوْقَفَتْهُ عَلَيْهِ. أَوْقَفَتْهُ عَلَيْهِ means it allows him to reach it. وَمَنْ عَدَلَ عَنْهَا, and anyone who diverts from it and turns away from it. لَمْ يَظْفَرْ بِمَطْلُوبِهِ, he will not attain what he's trying to look for. He's not going to gain what he wants to receive. وَإِنَّ لِلْعِلْمِ طَرِيقًا, knowledge has a path. مَنْ أَخْطَأَ, anyone who does a mistake in it, in that path. ضَلَّ وَلَمْ يَنَلِ الْمَقْصُودَ, that person becomes misguided. وَلَمْ يَنَلِ الْمَقْصُودَ, and he will not attain his objective, his goal. وَرُبَّمَا, and maybe there's a possibility. أَصَابَ فَائِدَةً قَلِيلَةً, the case may even be that he attains small benefit. فائدة قليلة, little benefit. مع تعب كثيرة, with مع تعب كثير, with a lot of tiredness. One will not even attain anything, and he's going to get lost and confused. Another one, on the other hand, he does attain something. He attains something very little, but the tiredness and the fatigue that he receives and endures is so high and it's so great, in comparison to the benefit that he is taking. So he's really getting little benefit. for a lot of hardship that he's put in. And why is the case for this? It's because the person hasn't taken the path for knowledge. There is a tariqah. Knowledge has a path. If you don't take that path for knowledge, you will get tired. You will wear out. And you will never attain what you're looking for. Or you will attain it. And if you do attain it, you will attain something very small and you're tired. 4 years of your life, you went and you sought, you went to seek knowledge. You come back, as they say, رَجَعَ بِخُفَّيْ حُنَيْنِ. You come back with nothing. Or you come back with little benefit. For the 4 years of hardship that you put in, for the tiredness, the sleepless nights that you endured, you really only attain little from it. But when the person takes the correct path, the correct methodology for knowledge, he attains a lot of benefit in a very short period of time. And all of that is based upon what, brothers? The Sheikh is going to mention them, exactly what the path is and what is it that's going to allow you to be a strong student of knowledge. So this is a very frequent question that people ask, right? I want to be a student of knowledge, what do you advise me? This is the answer. Now,
يقول الزرنوجي في كتابه تعليم المتعلم وكل من أخطأ الطريق ضل ولا ينال مقصود ضل أو جل.
The author, he brings a statement of الزرنوجي. الزرنوجي, we mentioned him the other day. He's a book. He's got a book in Etiquette of Seeking Knowledge, in which he talks about manners that are needed by a student of knowledge. And I said that he is the student of who? Al-Marghinani. Al-Marghinani is the author of the Kitab Al-Hidayah, in which the Ahnaf, the Hanafis, it's a book that they have become amazed and mind-boggled with, Kitab al-Hidayah. And it has, as I said, over 70 different explanations, and Hawashi and Shuruh. It's the book, Az-Zayla'i, in his Kitab Nasbul Raya, Fi Takhriji Ahadith al-Hidayah. And Imam Az-Zayla'i is the book that he done Takhrij on, Kitab al-Hidayah. He is a student of Marghinani. Zarnuji is a student of Al-Marghinani. And his kitab used to be the most frequently well-taught book. Still is around the world, some places. It's very well-taught. But this kitab has some things in it that are big stream when it comes to seeking knowledge and etiquette. I remember hearing a sheikh of mine who said that there was an individual who studied the kitab Ta'alim al-Muta'allim. He took this book on board, he studied the etiquettes, and when he took the etiquettes of this book, he started to implement everything he learned from it. So one day he saw kids playing football, and he stood there as though he was caught by a magnet, just didn't move from his position. So they asked him, what happened to you? Why are you standing here like this? And he responded by saying, the teacher that teaches me, his son is playing football. Out of respect for the teacher, I'm standing here not wanting to walk away from his son. And the ghulu, extreme. Another one said, I've never ever spreaded my legs towards the direction of my teacher's house. So people can take the etiquettes extreme. And this book does talk about things that are a bit extreme, unnecessary. That isn't what the Sharia commands from you. But it's a kitab that has a lot of benefits in it. Has a lot of benefits in it. It's called Ta'aleem al-Muta'allim. In that book of his, he said, وَكُلُّ مَنْ أَخْطَأَ الطَّرِيقَ ضَلَّ. Powerful statement. Every person who does a mistake in the path, meaning he doesn't tread the correct path, and he falls on the wrong path, ضَلَّ, he becomes misguided. وَلَا يَنَالُ الْمَقْصُودَ, and he will not attain his objective. قَلَّ أَوْ جَلَّ, whether it's little or whether it's a lot. You as an individual are not going to attain what? You are not going to attain your objective, what you came out for. The reason is because you're taking the wrong path. And as you all know, the poet said, تَرْجُ النَّجَاةَ وَلَمْ تَسْلُكْ مَسَالِكَهَا إِنَّ السَّفِينَةَ لَا تَجْرِي عَلَى الْيَبَسِ. You're hoping for success and you have not tread on its path. Verily, the boat does not sail on the shore. A person sees a shortcut. He sees a shortcut. He's on a boat. He sees a shortcut. On the sea, it's far. He would have to go around the land. But if he cuts through the land, the duration is faster as he believes. So he takes the boat and he drags it on the land. Can he sail on the land? It's because he believes that he can see a shortcut. إِنَّ السَّفِينَةَ لَا تَجْرِي عَلَى الْيَبَسِ. Sorry, there's a path for this. There's no shortcut. This is how it goes. So if you're looking for success, it has a path. If you don't take its path, you're not going to attain success. You're not going to attain the objective that you're looking for. And this is one of the biggest problems that many people endure, which is lack of manhajiyyah. We're going to speak about that. The methodology of studying and memorizing is incorrect. You see, a person can memorize something wrong, totally wrong. And the reason is because the manhajiyyah is wrong, the methodology is wrong, the path is wrong. So this person is getting confused. Now,
وقال ابن القيم في كتاب الفوائد: الجهل بالطريق وآفاتها والمقصود يوجب التعب الكثير مع الفائدة القليلة. وقد ذكر هذا الطريق بلفظ جامع مانع محمد مرتضى ابن محمد الزبيدي صاحب تاج العروس في منظومة النبر تسمى أفرية السنة، يقول فيها: فما حاول غاية في ألف سنة شخص فخذ من كل فن أحسن. بحفظ متن جامع للراجح تأخذه على مفيد ناصح. وطريق العلم ولادته مبنية على أمرين.
The author رحمه الله, he brought the statement of Al-Allama ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyyah in his Kitab al-Fawaid. And this is a book we mentioned previously, it's a book of benefits, Al-Fawaid. Ibn al-Qayyim said, Al-Jahlu bit-Tariqi, ignorance of the path. Al-Jahlu bit-Tariqi, the person doesn't know the path of knowledge, the path for knowledge. Is ignorant of the path. The second thing he mentioned Ibn al-Qayyim after that is وَآفَاتِهَا أي وَجَهْلٌ بِآفَاتِهَا, an ignorance of the harms that are on the path. Not knowing that the harm that's gonna, you're gonna go through. That's the second. And al-jahlu bil-maqsood, which is wal-maqsoodi, ay wa-jahlu bil-maqsood, an ignorance of the maqsad, the ultimate goal. What is the ultimate goal in attaining knowledge or gaining knowledge or seeking knowledge? The ultimate goal is al-rif'at indallah, right? You want to be raised to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يَرْفَعِ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ دَرَجَاتٍ. Those three, having ignorance of those three. Al-jahlu bi-t-tariqi, ignorance of the path. Al-jahlu bi-afati t-tariqi, ignorance of the harms on that path. And al-jahlu bil-maqsoodi, an ignorant of why are you seeking knowledge for. Those three, Ibn al-Qayyim says, yujibu, it necessitates and it brings about التعب الكثير, a lot of tiredness. You become very tired. مع الفائدة القليلة, with little benefit. With those three, the person what? He becomes tired, and he leaves back with little benefit. Then the author, rahimahullah, he mentions this by a statement. He says, وَقَدْ ذَكَرَ هَذَا الطَّرِيقَ. Now he's going to go back to the first of what Ibn al-Qayyim mentioned. Ibn al-Qayyim mentioned how many things? Ignorance of how many things? Three. This chapter, it talks about which one of the three? The first one only. So the author goes back to the first one. The first one, which is al-jahlu bil-tariq, ignorance of the path, and not treading on the path, the methodology that's set. He says, وَقَدْ ذَكَرَ هَذَا الطَّرِيقَ. This path was mentioned بِلَفْظٍ جَامِعٍ مَانِعٍ. It was mentioned in a very comprehensive manner. By who? Muhammad Murtada ibn Muhammad al-Zabidi. Muhammad Murtada al-Zabidi, he mentioned a comprehensive definition of what it means, this path. Definition, very ta'rif and understanding and mafhum, which is jami' mani', very comprehensive. He's the author of the book Taj al-Arus. He's the one who authored the book Taj al-Arus. And this book, as I said the other day, is a sharah. It's an explanation of Qamus al-Muhit, written by Al-Fayruzabadi, rahimahullah. Taj al-Arus is a book which is an explanation of the dictionary book written by Fayruz Abadi. He says in a book of his, the author of this book, Taj al-Arusi, he doesn't say this statement in his book, Ataj Taj al-Arus, no. He's the author of Taj al-Arus. Okay? And his name is Muhammad Murtada ibn Muhammad al-Zabidi. في منظومة له. He says it in a madhuba of his, lines of poetry of his. Tusamma, which is called Alfiyyat al-Sanad. It's called what? Alfiyyat al-Sanad. Yaqulu fiha, which he says in it, Fama hawa al-ghayata fi alfi sana. Shakhsun fakhudh min kulli fannin ahsana. He says that there is no one who can attain his goal in seeking knowledge even in 1,000 years. Knowledge is too big. You can't finish it. You won't be able to reach the end of knowledge even in 1,000 years. It's too big. So what should I do then? فَخُذْ مِنْ كُلِّ فَنِّ أَحْسَنَةً. Take from every science the best of it. You won't get to the end of Nahu. You won't even get to the end of one science, let alone all the sciences. There's always more to learn than what you already know. So what shall I do? فَخُذْ مِنْ كُلِّ فَنِّ أَحْسَنَةً. Take from every science the beneficial, the greatest portion of it. As much as you can. How can I do that now? This is the tariqah, right? This is the tariqah and the methodology in which I can. The author is going to mention, he's going to mention for you two parts, or the poet's going to mention for you two parts. بِحِفْضِ مَتْنٍ جَامِعٍ لِلْرَاجِحِ تَأْخُوذُهُ عَلَى مُفِيدٍ نَاصِحِ. By memorizing a matan. A matan is like this book, like al-waraqat, like thalathatul usul. They're called mutun. Mutun is a plural. Matan is when it's singular. It means anything that's not poetry. Books that are not poetry are called matan. And originally the word matan in the Arabic language, it came from matnu dabba, ay dhahru dabba, the back of the back of the riding beast. Kitab just means book. Anything is kitab. The Quran is a kitab. But matan is more like anything that's not poetic. It's not poet. It's not poetry. And it's a book that's studied like this. Okay. It's the name of the matan is the wording of the author. Sharah is the explanation. Nadhm is lines of poetry. If the book is turned into a poetry, it's called nadhm. Manzuma. So you memorize بحفظ متن, you memorize a matan. This matan جامع للراجح. This matan, it is very comprehensive. It's جامع. It's a very comprehensive matan. Is that it? No, that's one. The second thing is تَأْخُذُهُ عَلَى مُفِيدٍ نَاصِحٍ. And you take it to a person who is ناصح, a sincere advisor, a person who would sincerely teach you it, a person who's clean-hearted. Not only that, he has أهليه, he has the rights to talk about these topics. You take it to a person who knows the science and you say, teach me this science. Do you know it? Yes. Can you teach me it? Yes. You take it from that person. So two things he mentions for you, the methodology of seeking knowledge. بِحِفْظِ مَتْنٍ جَامِعٍ لِلْرَاجِحِ تَأْخُوذُهُ عَلَى مُفِيدٍ نَاصِحِ. Is that you memorize a book, the author is going to speak about that, I'm not going to go into too much details, because a lot of people are confused in what to memorize and how to memorize it and etc. The second thing is, take it to a person who is learned, who's skilled, who knows this, who can unlock the treasures and the secrets that are in this book. You might memorize it and not know it. Naam. The author then says, فَطَرِيقُ الْعِلْمِ وَجَادَّتُهُ مَبْنِيَّةٌ عَلَىٰ أَمْرَيْنِ. Then we learned from this line of poetry, what did we learn? We learned that the path of knowledge, وَجَادَتُهُ جَادَ, as we said in the Arabic language, they use it for one or two meanings. One I said is وَسَطُ الطَّرِيقِ, the middle path. And some said it's the straight path, سَوَاءَ السَّبِيلِ, the path which is straight. That's why the Arabs, they say مَنْ سَلَكَ الْجَدَدَ أَمِنَ الْعِثَارَ. مَنْ سَلَكَ الْجَدَدَ أَمِنَ الْعِثَارَ. The Arabs, they say. Aya? Carry on.
فَطَرِيقُ الْعِلْمِ وَجَادَتُهُ مَبْنِيَةٌ عَلَى الْأَمْرَيْنِ مَنْ أَخَذَ بِهِ مَا كَانَ مُعَظِّمًا لِلْعِلْمِ لِأَنَّهُ يَطْلُبُهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ يُمْكِنُ الْوُصُولُ إِلَيْهِ.
So now the author is telling you that seeking knowledge and attaining knowledge is how many ways? فَمَا الْحَوَى الْغَايَاتُ فِي أَلْفِ سَنَةِ شَخْصٌ فَخُذْ مِنْ كُلِّ فَنٍ أَحْسَنَ بِحِفْظِ مَتْنٍ جَامِعٍ لِلْرَاجِحِ. That's the first one. تَأْخُذُهُ عَلَى مُفِيدٍ نَاصِحِ. It's the second. Which is, by memorizing a book and taking it to a person who has أهليه. So the author is going to say, he said to you, فَطَرِيقُ الْعِلْمِ, the path of knowledge, وَجَادَتُ, and it's correct, straight path is, مَبْنِيَّةٌ, is built upon, عَلَىٰ أَمْرَيْنِ, it's built on two things. مَنْ أَخَذَ بِهِمَا, anyone who takes it, كَانَ مُعَظِّمًا لِلْعِلْمِ, then he is a person who is honoring, glorifying knowledge. Again, the book is about تعظيم العلم, honoring knowledge. If you take these two paths, then you are truly honoring knowledge. لِأَنَّهُ يَطْلُوبُهُ, because he is seeking knowledge. مِنْ حَيْثُ يُمْكِنُ الْوُصُولُ إِلَيْهِ. He is taking knowledge and he's attaining and trying to seek knowledge in a way that will allow him to really reach the end of it, or really allow him to attain a portion of it. This will allow you to gain enough, a lot. Now he's going to tell us in details. Alhamdulillah. يهديكم الله والسلام عليكم. Now he's going to tell us the two that we mentioned in very good details.
فأما الأمر الأول فحفظ متن جامع للراجح فلا بد من حفظ، ومن ظن أنه ينال العلم بلا حفظ فإنه يطلب محالة. والمحفوظ المعول عليه هو المتن الجامع للراجح، أي المعتمد عند أهل الفن، فلا ينتفع الطالب أن يحفظ المضمور في فن ويترك مشهورا، كمن يحفظ ألفية الآثار في النحو يترك ألفية ابن مالك.
The author now goes into the first one. The first thing is فَحِفْظُ مَتْنٍ جَامِعٍ لِلْرَاجِحِ. Memorizing a matan. This matan is rajih. Rajih means it has the strongest opinion. Don't memorize a matan that the aqwal are marjuh. All the opinions are weak. What's the point of memorizing something that's got weak opinions? Are you with me, brothers? The matan that you're going to memorize is a matan that's... And a lot of the times, the mukhtasarat, the books that are summarized, should observe that anyways. Books that are summarized should observe the qawl al-rajah, strongest opinion. So the person is memorizing qawl, because you're a student of knowledge, you have no time to waste in memorizing, that comes later. Now, fi bidayat al-talab, at the early stages of seeking knowledge, you need to study qawl al-rajah, the strongest opinion. فَلَا بُدَّ مِنْ حِفْظٍ. Because later, that qawl al-rajih that was told you might be even not, it might not even be a qawl al-rajih to you. You might turn out to not agree with that opinion. But for now, the opinion that the scholars see to be rajih is what they put in the book. فَحِفْظُ مَتْنٍ جَامِعٍ لِلْرَاجِحِ. That you memorize a book which is jami'. Jami' means it brings all of the points. And it's rajih. فَلَا بُدَّ مِنْ حِفْظٍ. Brothers, it's necessary to memorize. وَمَنْ ظَنَّ أَنَّهُ يَنَالُ الْعِلْمُ عِلْمًا. Anyone who believes that he's going to attain knowledge بِلَا حِفْظٍ, without memorization, فَإِنَّهُ يَطْلُبُ مُحَالًا. He is seeking the impossible. Anyone who wants to gain knowledge and wants to attain knowledge and wants to be a person of knowledge, if he's trying to do it without no memorization, then brothers, it's impossible. It is impossible to attain knowledge without memorization. It's impossible. What you're running after is a mirage. You know what a mirage is? On a hot, sunny day, and you're on a clear road, when the sun hits the road, it's as though there's water in front of you. So you drive fast, the faster you drive, you think you're going to get there. But every time, it's moving forward. You just never get into it. That person, what they're trying to seek is that. It's a mirage. They're never ever going to get to it.